Hi, welcome to this week's Macworld video. I'm your host, Macworld Senior Editor Chris Breen. Although the MacBook Air garnered the lion's share of attention at the recent Macworld Expo, to my mind, the most important deal of that week was iTunes movie rentals. After all, this one deal has the potential to solve the long-standing problem of video on demand. With that in mind, I'd like to take this week's video and spend some time exploring iTunes rentals. We'll start by finding the movies you want to rent. You can begin looking for movies by clicking the Movies link on the store's homepage. The resulting page is dedicated to movies. Here you'll find new rentals, a collection of favorites within a particular genre, in this case Westerns, and the usual staff favorites that you find on other iTunes store pages. Along the left side of the page are the day's top movies for sale, and along the right are the day's top rentals. Below the rentals entry, you'll find top short films. These short films are for sale rather than for rent and cost $1.99 each. Pretty as this page is, it's not the best way to see what the store has for rent because it displays only a small collection of movies. There are better ways to find what you seek. One way is to go to the bottom left side of the page and click the All Movies link in the Categories section. This brings up the first of, as I film this, 36 pages of movies, with each page displaying 21 titles. If a movie has a Buy Movie button next to it, it means the movie is available for purchase. If a movie has a Rent Movie button, it can only be rented. And if it says View Movie, it can be purchased or rented. Yet even this arrangement requires that you sort through page after page to browse the store's catalog of movies. Let's look at a couple of other ways. The first is to choose Show Browser from iTunes View menu. This brings up the program's bare-bones browser. In this browser, select the Movies entry. To the right, you'll see a Genres column. Select a genre, and at the bottom of the window, a list of movies filed under that particular genre appears. To sort the rentals from the purchase-only movies, click the Price header. Movies that are for rent will have a View Movie button or a Rent Movie button. Those that are for sale will have a Buy Movie button. But wait, there's more. You can also locate rental movies by using iTunes search feature. Just choose Search from the store menu to produce the search window. Under the Power Search pop-up menu, choose Movies. Now enable the Search Movies that are available for rental option and click the Search button. A list of 150 movies for rent will appear below. You can sort these movies by name, time, genre, release date, price, and popularity. Note that sorting by name doesn't sort all rentals by name, but rather by the titles that appear in that particular list. When you click the More Results link, you'll be taken to another list of 150 rentals. Click More Results one more time, and as I film this, you'll see the final 60 results of the rental search. Alright, so now you've found a movie that you'd like to rent. What happens next? Let's take a look. To rent a movie, you must be running iTunes 7.6 or later. Just click a movie's Rent Movie button, and iTunes will prompt you for your Apple ID and password. Enter it, and the movie begins downloading. Movies are typically about a gigabyte and a quarter large, and take an hour or so to download over a reasonably fast internet connection. Once you've downloaded a movie, you have 30 days to watch it. And once you start watching it, you have 24 hours to complete watching it before the movie is automatically deleted from your computer, iPod, or iPhone. Sort of, and I'll get to that in a minute. Once you've downloaded a movie, you can move it to your iPod or iPhone, or you can play it on your computer. Notice that I said move rather than copy. Apple struck a deal with the movie company so that you don't have access to multiple copies of your rental. Only one copy can be used, so if you move it to your iPod, you can't watch it on your computer until you move it back to your computer from your iPod. Fortunately, the process for moving movies is pretty easy. Just plug in your iPhone or recent iPod. Rentals work only on the iPod Classic, third generation iPod Nano, and iPod Touch. Select it in iTunes source list and click the Movies tab. In this tab, you'll see your rented movies in the Rented Movies section of the window. Choose the movie you want and click the Move button. Finally, click the Apply button and the movie will move from your computer to the iPod or iPhone. Once on your iPod or iPhone, you can choose to move it back to the computer or delete it. Note that you can't move it to another computer and expect it to play. Now, about rentals in the 24-hour limit. The truth is that if you pause the movie on your computer, iPod, or iPhone, and don't do anything else with iTunes if it's playing on your computer, or your iPod or iPhone, you can unpause the device even after the 24 hours have expired and continue playing the movie. This is a boon for parents who can't start watching certain movies until after the kids go to bed and don't have time to finish a movie before they finally pass out on the couch. And there you have it, the basics for renting movies on your computer and playing them back on the computer, iPhone, or iPod. Now, the process for an Apple TV will be different. I will be covering that process as well as new Apple TV features when the Apple TV 2.0 update ships. In the meantime, thanks for joining me. I'll see you around.